good stuff to all the Man United fans that are watching.
Same.
Oh,
any of them are Man United fans.
Huh?
I wonder if any of these people watching are Man United fans.
I wonder, right?
Yeah.
On the Man United account. Curious. And it could be.
Hey.
What I was going to say is, what do you think of this look? Like, of this the glasses up here? I kind of like it.
I think that's something new, and I think you're onto something. I don't know if it will catch on, but it's definitely something new.
Well, dangly earrings were my thing.
That's true.
Kind of caught on.
Fingernail painting was your thing as well.
You already know the drip.
Yeah.
And people are copying. So what if they copy this? What if I like actually think this is super lame, but I want those e-boys to copy it?
Make it a hashtag, it'll catch on.
Yeah. Hey, Josh, we got a cool music video coming out Friday, don't we?
We do have a cool music video coming out Friday, and it's to a song called All Around the World that we made all around the world, and we shot the music video for it all around the world.
Yeah. It's a pretty great song.
It is. It is. I like that song.
I do have to say that this is probably my new favorite 99 song.
It's definitely up there for me, too. I don't know if I would say favorite, but it's definitely up there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's going to be super dope. I haven't seen the music video yet because we don't see it really.
Yeah.
But
we don't see it really, guys, just so you know, we don't really see the stuff before it goes out. So, like, we're just as excited as you are.
Like, you know? Usually when you see us like reacting to any video that we put out, it's never faked. It's always real.
We never watch anything before it goes out. Which is kind of cool in like a weird way, because like you don't know what to expect, and then you get to watch the video and you're like, wow, this is actually really cool. You know?
Yep. For the most part, yeah.
Yeah.
So today we are having a conversation about, what is it about? Live.
We got some stuff ready for you.
Yeah, we got some stuff. We're going to talk about boy talk.
How we are. Boy talk. What's today?
I don't really know what to
they say. Boys Wednesday?
Is it Wednesday?
Let's look. I'm looking up my calendar.
It's no, I can't be.
And wait. I think it's Wednesday. Today's a Wednesday. It's the 27th. It's a Boys Wednesday, baby.
Welcome to Boys Wednesday.
Welcome to freaking Boys Wednesday. I got this nasty smoothie thing. It's disgusting.
It looks like it contains carrots.
I don't know what it can.
Not about it.
I don't know what it contains, but it's disgusting. Anyway, Josh, what's been inspiring you lately? You been finding some good music or seeing some cool dancing that has inspired you?
Yeah. I mean, I've been listening to a bunch of new songs that are coming out, but last night I watched Downfalls High. It's like a kind of like a movie, I would say, a visual album from like Machine Gun Kelly, and it has like a bunch of different people acting in it.
Sydney, what's her face?
Sydney, Maggie Lynn, Lil Huddies is acting in it.
Yeah.
And I think it was super dope. The visuals in there and everything, just they looked super cool. So that's
Lil Huddy and Sydney made out.
Yeah.
Or did they make out or did they kiss?
They actually, I don't know if I should spoil it, but there's a child in there.
They have a kid?
No, they don't. Okay, it's very, like, you have
I'll
to
just watch it.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. My God, Lil Huddy's getting it.
Lil Huddy.
Good for him, man. That's really awesome. He's like with Travis Barker and all those people that are super cool.
He has a song.
He does?
Yeah.
What do you think about his song?
First Century Vampire is called.
Little Huddy song. Is it cool if I just listen to it really quick?
Where? 20 minutes in.
Probably produced by Travis Barker. It's pretty cool,
right?
I like the music video.
Yeah. So that's what I've been inspired by lately. What about you?
Century Vampire. No. That's cool. I like that.
I don't know what you just did, but yeah.
I just learned.
You just bar a whole fret? Is that what I do?
Yeah, yeah. So basically what I'm doing is I'm just doing one, two. That's called the bar chord. And all this type of music, rock, all that stuff, all bar chords.
All bar chords, yeah.
So I just heard that and I was like, okay.
Ah, you figured it out. You're a music genius.
Nah, dude, you could do it. Anyone could do it.
That one. But what about you? What's you inspired by lately?
You know, there is this dude, Blood Orange. I don't know if it's a guy or a band, but Blood Orange.
Heard of him? Yeah.
Oh my goodness, man! Really incredible stuff. I love the way that he sings. He has like a very like Prince-like way of moving around and gliding around the musical melodies. But he's a really good guitarist and producer, and he produces most of his stuff, I'm pretty sure. So it's been really inspiring for me to listen to that. Blood Orange. And, I mean, of course, like, Dominic Fike's great.
Oh, yep.
Vampire. Oh, it's a vampire. I really like him and 070 Shake.
I don't know that one.
Bro, 070 Shake is just too good. I gotta put you on. She's badass. Should I just show you a little something by her?
Yeah.
You know that song? 5 a.m. when I walked in.
Couldn't
believe what I saw you. Yeah, that's her song. But she just is such a cool, like, dope person. And her voice is so good. The music video is awesome. That's her. Pretty cool.
That is dope. I like that. I like that a lot.
Yeah, I want to be your friend one day, maybe.
Maybe one day.
Dude, she's just so dope. And I love, okay, so she's playing like a role of like a very masculine, you know, woman. That, and I think it's like really cool because like she's just kind of flipping the narrative.
Yeah, you don't see that.
No, and it's cool because she's like just like this dope ass girl who's like a part of this gang kind of in this music video, and they just go around like effing stuff up, and it's just like dope. It's like makes you feel cool.
Oh, that's tight.
Yeah, she's a big inspiration for me right now.
Yeah.
Yeah. What did we talk about? What did you do for the All Around the World music video? I'm so curious. Where did you go? Where did you shoot?
I literally went in my forest right there in my backyard. Really? I went, there's like a pathway through the middle of it. So there's trees on either side, and it was It hadn't been snowing for like a month. It just didn't snow at all.
Oh, wow.
The one day that I went out to do the music video, it started snowing, so it looks super dope, and there's a lot of it's coming down heavy in the music video, so
That's so sick.
yeah.
Talk about like a perfect timing type of deal, right?
Yeah. And it's been so weird though. The weather here has been so weird. I can't even like go outside now because it's so cold. But last week it was only like -5, which is not even bad here. It's supposed to be like really bad at this time, but now it's like -30. I had to shoot something out on my deck yesterday night, and it was like,
Oh.
and I had to wear a t-shirt for it.
Jeez, you're insane, bro. I don't know how you do it.
What did you do? What did you do for the shoot?
I went all around LA.
Nice.
The Hollywood walk of like the stars. There in front of everyone, and I felt like kind of like a little bit embarrassed because I was like, oh my God, I feel so like weird. All these people are watching me. But I think the shots are gonna be worth it, and I think the fans are really gonna like it. And I walked around like near like Capitol Records
Oh yeah.
shot like out there in the middle of the street and almost got hit by a car a couple times.
Tight.
But it was cool. It's nice to like be doing 99 music videos again. I've missed it so much, and I miss like being with everyone so much. So I'm like really excited. Hopefully I can see them again soon.
Soon.
Oh.
Soon.
Soon.
Yeah, those are all super iconic locations in LA, and then I feel like everybody should go and see in their lifetime if they can. Everybody's got to go to LA just to see it, you know?
Yeah, I agree.
Even though, like, I feel like everybody thinks LA is just all just pristine glitz and glamour. And, like, you really go to LA, you go to, like, Burbank, NoHo, or, like,
It's
any.
like 60% glamour and like 40% like kind of sketch.
I would even say like 50-50 maybe.
Yeah. People don't really think about how big LA is. LA is like kind of big. Well, maybe it's not big like that big, but it's just there's so much traffic. You feel like it takes like an hour to get anywhere.
Well, LA is not that big, but everybody calls everything around LA also LA. So, I mean, it kind of is all
True.
LA.
Yeah. All Southern California is just LA.
Yeah.
County San Diego? No, it's LA.
How's it shooting your movie over there? Do you have any like little sneak peeks or anything? Anything exciting?
Right here. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, it's going really good. I've been having a lot of fun. I'm getting along with the cast very nicely, and it's been definitely it's been challenging to film a movie during COVID. Everyone has to be super careful, and we've had to pause production a couple times because of COVID scares or stuff like that. So it's taking a little bit longer than we thought to film it, but it's turning out really good so far, and everyone's having a great time, and it's just a really exciting thing to be a part of, and I'm super excited for everyone to see it.
Well, that is very dope. I can't wait to see it either.
And it's cool because, like, there's a little bit of music involved. There's a lot of music in it. It's just cool. Like, I feel cool doing it. And when I'm on set and we're filming these scenes in these certain locations during doing these certain things that we're doing, I'm not going to give any details, but I can't say what I can't. But like, I'm there doing the thing. I just feel like, wow, this feels right and good, you know?
Well, that's great. I'm happy for you that you're enjoying your time out there shooting a dope music, not music video. Why was I gonna say music video?
Because
Movie.
you're thinking about the dope music video we're about to drop on freaking Friday, bruh.
Also that, of course. I've been saying drop a music video a million times these past years, so.
Yeah. But yeah, it's gonna be pretty dope. I'm excited to see this music video because I think it's gonna be cool that you know, we get to get reminded about everyone's, you know, cultures and stuff, because I feel like it's been a while since we've done a piece like that where people can actually see, you know, like where we're from and what makes us who we are.
Like, we did some music videos at home before, like in quarantine, but it was mostly just on in our house and stuff. And like the last time we showed anything like in a whole music video, all from different countries, like professionally, I mean Feel It Now was pretty good, but I think Summer in the City did it the best.
Mm-hmm.
One. So yeah. I mean,
over 3 years ago.
Yeah. So I think everybody's gonna get a little taste of what everyone like lives like, kind of where they live, what it looks like.
Really changed. Oh my god, bro, that is insane. Summer in the City. Oh, 2 years ago I got released on April 14th, 2018. So April will be 3 years old.
That's nuts.
Oh my days, that's mind blowing to think about, man. Time flies. Look at this, bro. First of all, and he looks like a superstar. Oh my, bro. Oh my god. Look at you. Who's that handsome man? He's about to do a Michael Jackson kick.
That tank. Why was I doing that?
Because you were just dope, bro. Yeah, do that Michael Jackson kick. Oh! I love this trio right here. These people are beautiful. Ew! Who's that kid? Let's go, Diarra. Aww. Wait, is this shot right here? Like, you know, in the beginning of movies, like when you watch it, it's like a city and then like rolls in and like fades into something else.
Uh-huh.
It's like a certain film company.
Warner Bros.
Is this it? Hold up. Did you see that?
It has to be. It looks.
Wait, I got it. I'm gonna slow it down. I'm gonna slow it down and we're about to freak out right now.
That's what it is.
Hey, man.
Warner Bros.
Warner Bros. Dude, I'm so jealous. You have a baseball in your hand.
This is from the Dodgers game we went to.
You went to. I wasn't invited.
You weren't there?
No.
Sorry. We went to a Dodgers game in LA without you? Dang.
An invite. That's cool. That's cool. I'm over it. It was forever ago. Change the subject. So, Marty just moved to LA with me.
I mean, I should.
Dude, you know how much fun I'd be? It's gonna happen one day, I believe.
One day soon.
It's gonna be so much fun.
And we'll get tattoos and make music like every day.
Get tattoos. Make music. Eat some food.
Chat it.
Mug thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have any covers coming out soon?
I mean, I'm supposed to.
Ooh.
Got one, you know. I got a new cover, and I'm really excited about it. And I worked really hard on it, and I might have played the song like 30 seconds ago.
I know what it is.
What'd you say?
I know what it is.
He knows what it is. Yeah, it's a pretty cool cover, man. I'm excited. I worked really hard on it, and now I'm just waiting to drop it. I just don't know what day to drop it. Yeah, I'm still waiting to hear when I should do so. I'm excited. Do you have any more covers coming soon?
I want to get I want to start working on one and finish one before we leave. But
where?
Somewhere. Somewhere.
You and your family?
No. We already announced this, dude.
No, we did.
We said we're going to come back very soon. So, yeah. But not where. We didn't say where.
Oh, okay. Then we are going to go somewhere.
Yes. So before we do go somewhere, I want to do another one and get one kind of done. But I did just release one.
I'll take you on to mama. Dude,
that's right there.
You killed that song, bro.
Thank you, dude. You killed helping me make it sound super swaggy.
Hey, that's what Potter with a laptop. What'd you say?
Harry Potter with a laptop.
I want to say it one more time. It really boosts my ego.
Harry Potter with a laptop.
Oh, thanks, man. I appreciate you being so sweet. Harry
Potter with a laptop to make it sound good. That'd be like Inception.
Dang. That'd be pretty cool. That'd be Josh.
Yep.
I don't know.
Is it time for a dance break?
I think it's time.
Play it in stuff.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Ow! Oh, God.
You good, bro?
Wonderful.
Are the comments loading for you, by the way?
What?
Are the comments loading for you?
Yeah.
Oh, they're not loading for me. I can't see what they're commenting.
They're just laughing. Oh, my God. Miga sua loca. I don't know what that means, but...
Miga sua loca!
Look what I have.
I think that means that we're... What? Are you taking my place in Now United?
No. Okay, you want to hear a story? So, when... last time we were in Dubai, I left my rainbow look on a bus. So, they couldn't find any new rainbow looks, so they sent me one of yours, because you have, like, three pairs of pants.
What the?
And then I just had to take off your flag and put mine on.
That's so funny. You better keep that for forever.
Yeah. You can't throw away a flag. You can't do that.
No.
I'm half American.
Exactly. You should wear both.
Yeah. I could.
Josh, who wears the pants in our relationship?
We both have moments, I think.
I don't know. I think we're pretty equal. I don't think we're like that.
Can you explain to me what wearing pants in a relationship means fully? I've heard it a million times, and I just never have really fully understood it.
So basically, wearing the pants is like the one that makes the money. It's like
like plans out a date, plans out like,
yeah, and they kind of have control over things like, we're gonna go out tonight and we're gonna do this and we're gonna come back here and it's gonna be, you know, it's like they're the ones who are always like making stuff happen.
I feel like we have our moments, both of us.
Yeah, but also like we're not in a lot of situations where we get to make decisions ever.
That's also a fact.
So, who knows? Maybe you would wear the pants, maybe I would wear the pants, but.
And when I wear the pants, you wear a dress.
Exactly.
Yeah.
2021, baby.
I did a TikTok in a dress.
No, you didn't.
I swear I did.
Did I duet it?
No. Yeah, you should.
Wow, you're such a poopy head. I haven't used TikTok in so long, man. I need to start posting.
Dude, posting on TikTok gets, like, fun and also annoying sometimes. And it's, I don't know. There's sometimes that I'll make, like, 5 TikToks within, like, a half an hour. And then there's sometimes where I just won't make a TikTok for, like, months. And that's this time now.
I feel that. I don't feel it, but I see where you're coming from.
Yeah.
This is such a funny frame that I paused on. She's like 13 there. That's insane.
13?
Right? Wasn't she 13 when she joined that? 14?
Ever met her, she was 14. I think she had an audition at 13. The first ever in her country. Right?
Is she 18 now?
She's 18 now. But it couldn't be. It couldn't even be 14. She had to be 15. I don't know. I was either 16 or 17. So I was.
I was definitely 16.
And I was definitely 17.
And, yeah. I was 16. I was 16. And he was 17.
Yeah.
We were 16. And back when I wasn't so mean. I was just a kid then, and we used to be friends. Then we figured out we had the same birthday, and I was like, okay, you're gonna be my best friend. And I love you till the world ends. You're my best friend. You're my best friend. Yeah.
That was beautiful. I was going to do ad libs for it. Oh, I'm back.
You're going to do ad libs?
I was going to do ad libs for it, but I knew it would be delayed and sound terrible.
Best friend. Hey, grr, woo. You're my best friend. Damn, dude, I freaking miss you. This is annoying.
Miss you, dude. How's Oregon? What's it like there?
I'm like, be with me.
Okay.
Can only. Yeah, Oregon's chill, man. It is cold. I mean, not nearly as cold as where you are, but I'm not used to being cold. But I've been enjoying it a lot. I've just been spending a lot of time in my hotel room lately because we haven't been able to film. But hey, it's coolio. It's coolio. I just made up a new word. What's there to do in Alberta right now?
What's what?
What's there to do in Alberta right now?
Really nothing. There's lockdown still. So basically everybody's in their own houses. And I... Basically, what I do in a day is I wake up, work out, and do content until there's a hockey game on, and I'll watch the hockey game, and then I'll watch a movie and go to sleep. That's pretty much
really
day, usually.
What movies have you been watching?
I was just watching Hercules, like the original, like cartoon. I don't know. I haven't seen it in so long, so I was like, I'm going to watch Hercules today.
That's cute. Was it good?
I'm not done, but yes, it's good.
Nice.
Yeah. Well,
great, man.
You've been watching Game of Thrones, right?
I've been watching Game of Thrones, and I'm actually obsessed. I've spent over 40 hours watching it, I think. I'm on
something. Thank you.
Bro. Yeah. You've watched it?
I watched it, yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What? I watched it
a long time ago. I think 2018 sometime when we were home. When we were home in 2018 sometime, I just binged the whole thing, which is like 80 hours worth of watching. And or not even 80 hours. It's more than that. It's so much more than that.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I binged through it. The first four seasons are kind of boring, and then it just is nuts.
First four are boring, bro? I've been loving.
Where are you? Like, what season?
I don't want to spoil it. I'm on season four.
Okay. You're about to...
No, okay. Okay, let me say...
So much better, and you're about to become so much more obsessed then.
I want to say, when the mama bear... got killed.
I can't remember this.
Wait, hold up. I'm gonna try to do it without spoiling anything.
Oh, in the supper. Wait.
Wedding. Think about the wedding.
The wedding.
Do you not remember? Wedding.
Which wedding? There's a lot of weddings.
I know there's a lot of weddings, but there's a wedding, between the king of the north, and the king of the north found his hot girlfriend wife. And
his hot girlfriend wife.
They got her pregnant and they went to a wedding. And
oh yeah. Oh my goodness. That blew my mind. I was actually watching the screen and I think my jaw was on the floor.
Bro, I almost cried.
Is that the last thing you've seen?
No, I'm like two episodes ahead of that, I think. Or three. Okay,
so I think that's like the most exciting thing to happen so far.
Yeah.
You're about to lose your mind. Like, I'm telling you, dude. Oh, my God. There's so many, like, plot twists and, like, crazy things that go on that you're literally, like, yeah.
I'm so excited now.
Yeah. If you like it now, you're going to like it even more.
Oh, my God. Targaryen or whatever her name is so bro. She's so badass. Am I allowed to say that word?
Yeah, you gotta be able to say that word.
Dude, she is so cool. I love what she stands for, what she fights for.
She's dope. She really is.
Yep.
And just the fact that she has dragons, man, that's just the coolest thing ever.
Yeah, you should marry her.
I should, because I am Jon Snow, and I'm
Jon Snow. I look more like him. I have dark hair.
It's not about the looks. It's about...
About what?
I don't know. I just feel like I relate to Jon Snow. If you get farther into it, you're gonna be like, oh, wait, Josh is Jon Snow.
Okay.
Hopefully.
If you say so. I trust you. Jon Snow. You don't know nothing, Jon Snow. He's dope, too.
He's so dope. He's like... He's my spirit animal.
Then why don't you say your spirit animal's a wolf? Because you're a dragon.
I'm a dragon and a wolf.
Oh, is that what you'd always say?
No. I don't know. I don't know what I say when people ask me a spirit animal. I don't know.
What do I say?
You say... What do you say?
Josh. It's.
Is it a penguin or something?
No, but I think I might have said that maybe once in an interview.
Yeah, I think you did. I can't remember what you said. What do you say?
I'm a dolphin.
Okay, yeah.
I'm just gliding through life.
That's nice.
I'm swimming and vibing and gliding.
Jumping and
soaring and spitting water through my nose.
Do you remember when I asked everybody if they liked dolphins?
Yes.
That was like...
I have some interesting facts about dolphins. I think they never sleep. They only sleep with their left side of the brain and then the right side of the brain. When they're swimming, they never sleep. They rest the left side of the brain and swim with the right side. And then when they're done resting that side, they switch to the other one.
That's nuts.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure a lot of fish do that.
That's nuts.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure sharks do it too. Because think about it. You don't see a shark sleeping.
That's true.
Well, they're always moving. But it's really interesting.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Wow. Thank you for that information.
And thank you for freaking doing this live with me, my friend.
Thank you, brother.
Yeah, brother. You're like my twin brother that's a year older than me.
Yeah.
Okay, dude, let's end this thing.
Yeah, I don't know. We're just rambling on now.
Yeah, we're talking about Game of Thrones for like 20 million minutes.
Yeah. All right, guys. Well, thank you for joining in. That was the Nosh live stream today. We have a music video coming out on Friday. And happy Boys Wednesday.
Happy Boys Wednesday. I completely forgot we were live for a second. I the comments aren't rolling in and everything's
frozen. You just thought you were on a call?
I literally felt like we're on a call, but okay. Love you, man.
Love you too, dude.
Peace.
Peace out.